Good morning students, today we are going to discuss about the cell cycle control system in this video. So the protein complex, the number of proteins, the protein complex that are involved in controlling the cell cycle are classified into two categories. One is cyclin, another is cyclin dependent kinase. So what is cyclin? Cyclin is just the regulatory protein. What is cyclin dependent kinase? All of you know kinase is the enzyme which is normally involved in the phosphorylation or phosphate addition, removal, such type of reactions. So here cyclin dependent kinase means kinase whose activations depends upon the cyclins. That is known as cyclin dependent kinase. Okay, so this is the catalytic unit which act as a protein kinase. So cyclin, come to cyclin first. Cyclin first discovered by Hunt in 1982 while studying the cell cycle in sea orchids, and the name cyclin is given to this type of protein because their synthesis and degradation are occurred in the cell cycle in a sequential manner. Okay, their concentration varies in cyclical fashion during cell cycle. This is due to two things. One is fluctuation in cyclic gene formation expression, and second is destruction of cyclin protein by ubiquitin mediated proteasomal pathway. Actually, cyclins are different types on the basis of at which stage of this cell cycle they are binding with the CDK. I am making it more simple. Listen please. What is the relationship between cyclin and CDK? Cyclin are a special type of protein which regulate CDK, and CDK control the proceeding or activities of cell cycle by phosphorylating different target proteins. And the role of cyclin is to activate CDK by adding phosphate by adding with it. That means cyclin comes, let this cyclin, okay, and this is CDK. After the formation of a cyclin CDK complex, CDK will activate, and that respective CDK will causes the phosphorylation of target proteins, and the phosphorylated target protein will carry out function in the cells or any proceeding in the cell cycle or any improval in the cell cycle, like this. Okay, so cyclin dependent kinase are the protein kinase, and they are coming under the category of serine 309 protein kinase. Okay, normally cyclin dependent protein kinase target proteins and phosphorylate them at serine and threonine residue, amino acid residue. Okay, so let's come to the type of cyclin. Let's explain you how the CDK and cyclin act or function. I'm taking an example here. Suppose this is the G1 phase of cell cycle. Okay, and in the G1 phase, certain activities are required. Certain proteins are required, certain mechanisms are required for which some essential proteins are need to be active. Here is that proteins whose activation will carry out the function that is needed to be done in G1 phase. For the activation of this protein, The protein is need to be phosphorylated. Addition of a phosphate group must be occurred in that protein. And this phosphorylation reaction, that means adding phosphate group to this protein, is done by the CDK enzyme, cyclin dependent kinase enzyme, which is a protein kinase enzyme, which causes the phosphorylation of this target protein at a serine or a threonine region. After that, the target protein will activate or carry out its function. But this thing will occur. CDK can phosphorylate this target protein only after it binds with the cyclin. That means cyclin CDK complex will activate CDK. Before that, CDK is in inactive state. Binding of cyclin with the CDK make the formation of cyclin CDK complex. After that, CDK can phosphorylate the target protein at serine or threonine residue. After that, the active protein or target protein can do any type of function that is required to be done in G1 phase of cell cycle. Okay. So, in that G1 phase, certain cyclin are there. For example, I am taking the example of G1 cyclin. Okay. So, when G1 cyclin binds with the CDK of G1 stage that presents in the G1 stage, or CDK that presents inside the cell, after that the CDK will be activated. Okay. So, after the completion of the job, after the finishing of the activities that is needed to be done by the target protein, now CDK need to be inactive. There is no necessity of any phosphorylation again. So what will be done after that time? When it is become clear that already the function need to be done is done, at that time degeneration or destruction of a cyclin start. So when cyclin will destroy or degraded by the proteasomal degradation pathway or ubiquitin pathway, which we will discuss in the next video. The cyclin dependent kinase and cyclin complex break. And then what will happen? The target proteins, which is already has phosphorylated, will undergo dephosphorylation by the phosphatase. Okay. So one thing you should remember, that in each stage of cell cycle, different types of cyclin proteins are activated or are synthesized, and accordingly different target proteins are undergo phosphorylated by the CDK. Okay. So this is all about the cyclin and CDK controlling system for the cell cycle phenomena. Okay, how the cell cycle is controlled by cyclin and CDK. I am repeating the information in a revised manner. Okay, first two proteins remember, one is cyclin, another is CDK. What is the role of cyclin? It is a regulatory protein and it will bind with CDK. After binding of cyclin with CDK, the complex will activate CDK, and that CDK will cause the phosphorylation of the target proteins. Okay, and after the phosphorylation of the target proteins, that protein will carry out the certain function that is needed to be done in that stage of the cell cycle. After that, the cyclin will be degraded by the proteasomal degradation pathway. So when cyclin will be degraded, there is no complex now between cyclin and CDK. So if there is no complex, again CDK will undergo inactivation. CDK will be inactive. After the inactive of CDK, the protein which has been phosphorylated to do a certain function in the cell, it will undergo dephosphorylation by the help of the enzyme phosphatase. Okay? Thank you.